Hello students, how are you all? I am Krupali Patel and I am going to teach you science standard 4th. Now we are going to start with the chapter of standard 4th. Second chapter, that is reproduction in plants. Okay? So now in reproduction in plants we are going to study how the reproduction in a plant takes place. Okay, so now what is the big idea that we are going to learn in this chapter? So one of the ways by which plants reproduce is by the help of flowers. So first point to remember is that flower is the reproductive part of a plant. Okay, a new plant grows from a seed. Yes, you all know that a new plant grows from a seed. Okay, now, which are the different things which we are going to learn in this chapter? Okay, things to learn. Number one, first thing which we are going to learn is parts of a flower. So, we are going to study parts of flower. In third standard, we have studied parts of a plant. Now, we are going to study about parts of flowers. Then the second point is pollination and fruit formation. So we are going to study about pollination and formation of fruit. Then germination. Yes, in third also we have seen germination. Again we are going to see about germination. And the fourth point is seed dispersal. We are going to study about seed dispersal. Okay. Now, the different parts of a flower. So, parts of a flower. Here is a beautiful picture given of a flower. So now, most flowers turn into fruits. Okay, the first point is very important. What is the first point? A flower, most of, not all the flowers. Most of the flowers turn into fruits. Fruits means we are eating the fruits. So, the flower will convert into fruit. Okay, now, a flower is also known as the reproductive part of a plant. Yes, as I told you earlier, a flower is known as the reproductive part of a plant. Okay, typically a flower has many parts. Yes, as you can see in the diagram, the flower is having lots of parts. Okay, now we are discussing one by one about the different parts of a flower. So, the petals are the most colorful and attractive part of a flower. Okay, you can see in the diagram petal. The red color is the petal. Okay, so all the flowers are having attractive petals. So, petals are of different color and different size and different shape, and they are the most attractive part, means they are very beautiful. Petals are very beautiful. Okay, then the anther and pollen grains form the male parts of a flower. Okay, now the flower have been divided into two parts. So number one is the male part and the number two is the female parts. Okay, the male parts. So, male parts includes what? Anther and pollen grains. So, now we will see in the diagram. Where is the anther? Okay, this yellow portion is known as anther. You can see this yellow portion, they are known as anther. Okay, and then pollen grains. So, pollen grains are present on top of anther. Okay, so these two consist of the male parts of a flower. Second is female part. So, the style, stigma, ovary forms the female part of the flower. Okay, so style, stigma. Stigma, you can see here the top portion, stigma. And here the round portion is the ovary. So they form which portion? The female portion of a flower. So now I will show you all these parts in a real flower. Okay students, here I have taken a hibiscus flower. I will show you all the parts of the flower. First we will start with the pedicel. This is pedicel. Okay. Then sepals. This green color part which you can see are the sepals. So one by one I will take out the sepal and I will show you all the other parts of the flower. Okay. So we have removed the sepal. Now the next part is petals. The next part is petals. So we will remove the petals. This is the colorful and the most attractive part of the flower. These are petals. Okay, now I have removed the petals. Okay, now this portion, this is stigma. This is the female reproductive part of the flower. Okay, now this yellow portion which you can see, the yellow portion, this is anther. Okay, this is anther. And inside the anther, there are pollen grains. Okay, now this is inside, this is the ovary of the flower. Okay, now one more part is there which we will see. When we open this part, we can see another part, this white color portion. Okay, so this white color portion is known as style. This white color portion is known as style. Okay, so what happens is this red color stigma and this white portion and the ovary here, one stigma, style, this white color, you can see white color portion, style. So this red color stigma, white color style, and this down here ovary forms the female reproductive system. And this yellow portion anther and the pollen grains form the male reproductive system. Okay, so these were the parts of the flower. The sepals, the petals, the anther and pollen grains, the style, stigma and ovary. So these are all the part of a flower. Okay students, so I think you understood this. Rest of the chapter we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you.